Hello, welcome to Internet Culture. This is Mark Tasman coming to you from the Digital Arts and Culture Media Lab and Research Module. This video covers chapters 1.4 and 1.5 in the book Internet, the history of the Internet, centralized, decentralized, and distributed networks. Look at their structure. What would happen if you took out one of those points? What happens to the network? The integrated pattern of human knowledge, belief, and behavior that depends upon the capacity for learning and transmitting knowledge to succeeding generations. Who invented the World Wide Web? Where was it invented? Technology in 2008 presidential politics. Interesting ideas about computer literacy. You can see there's a sequence of videos. You can watch how various remarks played out in the campaigns. Digital access index. Which parts of the world are highly networked? Which parts of the world are lacking in access to the network? You can see a map of, actually it's a photograph of the Earth at night, and you can see all of the lights at night. You can see the electrical grid light up. Now, this electrical grid also corresponds, its infrastructure, so it corresponds to access to the network. Pay attention to those areas that are lighted up, and I've also created a little animation for you. The lime green, the bright green colors, are countries that have high access. The red countries, the red parts of the world, are places where there is limited, the lowest access in the world. Where are those parts of the world? This is part of the digital divide. The digital divide suggests that there is a divide not only between countries themselves, between rich countries and poor countries, but also a divide within a country itself, between urban and rural areas. This is fascinating to me, this European Union declaration. They say our society is now defined as the information society. A society in which low-cost information and ICTs are in general use, or as the knowledge-based society, to stress the fact, and I cannot stress this enough, the fact that the most valuable asset is investment in intangible human and social capital, and that, wait for it, the key factors are knowledge and creativity. Imagine a world where these factors are the most important things. The most valuable asset is investment in intangible human and social capital, and that the key factors are knowledge and creativity, not natural resources, not gold mines, not oil wells, knowledge and creativity of humans. Hey, who owns the internet? It's not owned by anyone. There's an organization called ICANN. Who is ICANN? Follow that link. Find out who ICANN is. What are their primary principles? They protect the internet from capture, from an entity seizing control. They protect the internet from pirates. Ironically, ICANN's site is often hacked. As I am producing this video, I cannot access ICANN.org, so I've furnished a link to the Wikipedia site that talks about ICANN. What is the difference between proprietary and open source? What's a proprietary browser? What's an open source browser? The Future of the Internet and How to Stop It by Jonathan Zittrain. You can watch a video. It's a 20-minute video, but it's worth watching. He's an entertaining character. Devices like the iPod are proprietary. Cable boxes, DVRs, they're proprietary. For example, a PC you can build yourself, right? You choose the parts you want. Like an old American car, you can change the motor oil yourself, right? You can modify it. You can increase the horsepower. He says devices like the iPod are locked down, and it stifles creativity. It stifles invention. Don't forget to check the deadline for essay one, comments, and the deadline for quiz three. Until next time, this is Mark Tasman, and I will see you on Facebook.